Gravitational waves are ripples in the fabric of space-time, predicted by Einstein's laws of general relativity. But they're incredibly difficult to detect. To see them, you need a detector that can accurately measure distances 10,000 times smaller than a proton. That's crazy! That's like trying to measure the distance from our sun to the nearest star to an accuracy of the width of a human hair. But we have a technology on Earth that can do that. LIGO, the Advanced Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory. And back in November 2015, on a Monday morning, LIGO detected the first gravitational wave that humans have ever directly observed. Where they came from and what this means for space science is nothing short of mind-blowing. This is the story. A long, long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, I'm not kidding, 1.3 billion years ago and 1.3 billion light years away, two black holes were stuck in a perilous orbit around one another, getting closer and closer. Black holes are incredible objects. The pull of their gravity, the amount they bend space-time, is so strong that no light can escape them. No one knows what exists in the center of a black hole, as normal physics completely breaks down. What we do know is that they're infinitely dense. One of these orbiting black holes was 29 times the mass of the Sun, and the other was 36 times the mass of the Sun. But they were only about 200 kilometers wide, which is tiny in comparison to the Sun, which is over a million kilometers wide. And these black holes were orbiting each other really, really fast, about the same frequency as the blade on a blender. Imagine that, such massive objects rotating so quickly. These orbiting masses created ripples in the fabric of space-time called gravitational waves, and the closer they orbited, the bigger these waves got, until the black holes collided at half the speed of light. And when they merged, they formed a new black hole that rang kind of like a bell, throwing out colossal amounts of energy as gravitational waves, until it settled into a perfect sphere. And all of this happened in 0.2 seconds. And in the collision, they turned a huge amount of mass into gravitational wave energy. They lost a mass equal to 3 times the mass of the Sun, which got turned into gravitational wave energy by Einstein's equation E equals mc squared. This created a huge wake of gravitational waves that ripped out in all directions at the speed of light. And this is the thing that gets me. Over that last fifth of a second, this collision released more than 10 times more energy than the total output of all the stars in the entire rest of the universe. It just completely boggles the mind. Meanwhile, on Earth, at this exact time, our planet was looking very different to what we see now. It was a barren wasteland. There was no grass or trees, in fact, no plants or animals at all. Life at this stage had only come as far as microscopic multicellular creatures that lived in the sea. And while the gravitational waves tore through space towards us, all of the complex life on Earth evolved and grew. Plants and animals developed, amphibians crawled on land, there was extinctions, reptiles and dinosaurs and mammals, more extinctions, primates evolved into all of human civilization, right up until Saturday, the 12th of November 2015, when the scientists at LIGO turned it on to begin their initial tests. A mere 2 days later, and the gravitational waves flew past us, and the first direct detection of gravitational waves on Earth was made. And that sound, it's actually what these waves sounded like. Even though gravitational waves are ripples in space-time and not ripples in the air, they vibrate at similar frequencies, so we can actually turn them into sound waves and listen to them. It might not sound very impressive, but detection of gravitational waves means a huge amount for science. The results of this detection have already been profound. This is the very first time that black holes have been directly detected. In fact, gravitational waves are the only way you can directly detect them. Consider this. All of our knowledge about the universe to this date has come to us through telescopes that measure light from the electromagnetic spectrum, like radio waves, visible light, X-rays, or through detectors that measure subatomic particles. But all of these existing telescopes are completely blind to gravitational waves. This means that gravitational wave astronomy is an entirely new thing, a whole new way to observe the universe. And it has already solved some important science questions. Gravitational waves exist. Black holes exist. and gravitational waves travel at the speed of light. Here's how the LIGO detectors work. There are two L-shaped buildings, one in Hanford, Washington, and another in Livingstone, Louisiana, that make up LIGO. And also there's another detector called Virgo, which is in Italy, near Pisa. Having several detectors on Earth means that scientists can verify a signal from space by seeing if it appears at all of the different detectors. And they're far apart because it means that they can see roughly in what direction the wave is coming from by triangulating the signal. Even with these waves travelling at light speed, there's a delay of a few milliseconds between each of the detectors. Each of these L-shaped buildings houses a thing called a laser interferometer, where a laser is produced, then split into two beams which each fly down a 4 kilometer long arm, and then they're reflected off a 40 kilogram pure silicon test mass, which is hung from the ceiling. It's hung from the ceiling on a series of pendulums to insulate it from the outside disturbances like trucks moving past or people sneezing. When you're trying to detect distances with a sensitivity less than the nucleus of an atom, getting rid of external noise is very important. Each arm bounces the laser back and forth 400 times to make the arm effectively 1,600 kilometers long. And each time around, the laser's boosted to make it stronger. Then after its journey, the light is collected and recombined in such a way that if the arms are the same length, the light from each arm cancels out, producing no signal. But if a gravitational wave ripples past, it'll stretch or contract each of the arms, making the light from each arm arrive at the detector at slightly different times. That means that when they're recombined, they will no longer fully cancel out and a signal will appear. And this is exactly what happened on the 14th of November. It's crazy to me to imagine that if they had turned on this detector just 2 days later, then they would have completely missed this signal that had been travelling towards us for 1.3 billion years. This makes me wonder what other signals from deep space we've already missed, and what's still out there screaming towards us waiting to be discovered that we just don't know about yet. In fact, at the time I made this video, LIGO's detected another even stronger black hole collision, and we can expect a lot more in the coming months and years. It's already achieved many of its science goals, but there's many more it's aiming for. For example, it might be able to give us a more accurate measure of how fast the universe is expanding, and so how much dark energy there is. It will hopefully be able to look at what makes stars go supernova, and might be able to probe the very nature of space-time and see if it's made of things called cosmic strings. But the most exciting thing is that we don't know what it'll find. This is one of the best parts of science when you've got a new tool to peer into a realm of reality that you've never been able to access before. Who knows what you'll find? Maybe you'll discover things that help explain some of the great mysteries of the universe, or maybe we'll find things that we can't explain at all, and then we have to come up with new physics. In any case, I find it super exciting, and I can't wait to see more results. So there you go, those are the basics of gravitational wave astronomy. Hey, I just wanted to say thanks for all the comments on my last video. I didn't get to reply to them all, but I did read them all, and the amount of positive feedback was amazing, and it just makes me want to carry on and make more and more of these videos, so thanks for that. As for this video, I didn't get to cover everything I wanted to. This field of gravitational wave astronomy is amazing. In 8 minutes, you can only cover so much. So if you're left with any questions, please put them in the comments and I'll try and reply to them, or I'll collect together the most popular ones and do something later, a Q&A or something like that. Also, I've set up a Patreon account, so if you want to help support me make these videos, go take a look at that. Otherwise, thanks for watching and I'll see you on the next video.